In September 2009, No Water, No Life embarked on a three-week expedition led by conservationist and photographer Allison Jones to raise awareness about the quality, availability, and usage of water along the Mara River. The team documented the impact of drought on people and wildlife, starting in the Mau Forest and continuing on to the Maasai Mara National Reserve and Tanzania's Lake Victoria. Kenya has a natural cycle of drought that occurs once every 10 years. But in the past decade, Kenya has been feeling the heat of climate change, and drought occurs with ever greater frequency, once every 2 to 3 years.
In East Africa anyway, we get tremendous droughts, normally followed by almost El Nino conditions. And this results in pasture being degraded, erosion taking place, rainfall patterns being changed by deforestation, and the rivers drying up. You know, the perennial rivers in the area are actually becoming pretty well extinct.
In 2009, Kenya had its third consecutive year of drought, threatening the livelihoods of already vulnerable populations. These Maasai pastoralists traveled 7 days without finding sources of food or water. They have lost approximately one-third of their herd.
You know, they're talking about the drought. They've walked almost 1,000 kilometers away to come here with their cattle. Their cattle are dying every time and then. So that's why they decided to move from where they're living up to here.
Increasingly, Kenya's population outstrips its land and natural resources. Conflicts over water and livestock fuel ethnic tensions and call into question issues of global security in the region.
In the past year or so, we have seen communities rise up with arms against each other, fighting over the scarce water resources, both for human consumption and for their livestock, which they are highly dependent on, especially the pastoralist communities.
The source of Kenya's environmental pressures can be found here, far from the pastoralists of the Maasai Mara, in the Mau Forest Complex, the country's largest forest ecosystem comprised of almost 1 million acres of canopied trees. It is the single most important water catchment in the Rift Valley in western Kenya, benefiting between 5 and 7 million people. The forest also feeds the headwaters of Kenya's 12 major rivers.
During the dry season, forests, in particular mountain forests, have been the largest moisture reservoir. There are five of them, and we call them here in Kenya the water tower of the nation. They are Mount Kenya, the Aberdare, Mount Elgon, the Sharangani, and the Mau Forest Complex. Of those five, the Mau Forest Complex is the largest. It is perceived as the most important water catchment of the entire country.
It is estimated that the Mau Forest and its watershed, it takes care of over a third of the country's population in terms of water, tourism, food, even livestock.
So this is just some examples of a clearer patch on the edge of the Mau Forest along the Sausa River. And you can see these tree trunks are absolutely thick with moss, which grows in this moisture-rich environment. It's just so full of water you can actually pull a piece of moss off the tree and squeeze. It's this massive sponge that drips water into the entire environment, and that's where the rivers start.
Encroachment into the Mau Forest began in the 1980s. But took a big leap forward in 2001 when President Moi and government agencies, including the land registrar and government surveyors, engaged in a fraudulent process of issuing title deeds to its constituents in exchange for votes. The land was gazetted and subdivided into parcels and exploited without plans for reforestation. Thousands of peasant families settled within protected reserves where they became dependent on the forest for their livelihoods and everyday needs. More than 25% of the forest cover has been lost in the last 15 years, leaving Kenya with a mere 1.7% of forest.
Eastern Mau is 100% gone.
100% gone.
Transmara Forest?
Close to 90.
90% gone.
Yes.
And the southwestern Mau Forest is all that is left.
All that is left.
Those of you who live here are aware that because the trees are gone, up here, it makes a difference in the rivers below the Mau Forest and below Nakuru. As the rivers go down, 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 all the way to Lake
there
Victoria.
There is a consequence. There is a consequence of the felling of tree here. We are seeing it. Yes, all of us, we want the environment. We want the environment to return the way it was. But we should consider some things. Should we blame the people, the illiterate people here? We should blame the government because of the former regime and the current one, the Kibaki. Because it is the one which failed to come up with a map load to care for our environment.
The current government is now faced with correcting these transgressions at the risk of escalating tensions such as the world witnessed in the wake of Kenya's post-election violence in 2008.
The government is going to have to force people out of the most essential section of the water tower by whatever means necessary.
Is that politically viable? What will happen to these people long term?
I don't know. They're going to need to be moved out. That is the unquestionable question. That's going to happen. Where they're going to go, where they're going to live, what they're going to do for a lifestyle, nobody knows.
I think it's true that 60% of Kenya's population are under 12. We're sitting on a volcano where the natural resources that there are already under pressure. In order to survive the population that we have, we've got to find other places where people can live.
If the action is not taken right now, in the area where we are, the issue of the Mau Forest itself and other forests, conservation of the Mara River is not only going to be a problem locally, it's going to be a problem globally.
In mid-2009, Kenya's parliamentary members established a Mau task force led by the Prime Minister himself, Raila Odinga. It is the first time an issue of sustainable development has moved to the center of the government's agenda. Now the political debate is how to implement the task force report.
Those without document, without title deeds, will be removed from the forest in a humane manner, but with no compensation. Those with title deeds or any other official documents, if those documents are valid and legal, they will be resettled or compensated. If those documents are not valid or not legal, they will be treated like illegal squatter. At the end of the day, the Mau Forest complex is a national asset, and we have to make sure that the forests are being secure for the entire nation.
The outcome of the Mau Forest issue will influence more than Kenyans alone. 160 million people in 10 countries share the downstream impacts of degradation in the Mau. Our last stop, a visit with the Amarti Primary School Choir and a message of conservation from the banks of the Mara River where they live.
Children are singing about, so they are appealing to everybody to actually conserve the environment so that we get water. Because without water, there is no life.